Scruffy!
Good morning, my darlings. Today has started off in a very floral way. I have just undone my weekly Freddy's flowers, and we've just had a huge delivery from a company called Arena Flowers, who I discovered on Instagram, and they are the UK's most ethical florist, apparently. They plant a tree for every bouquet sold, and they're also single-use plastic free. And I was not expecting quite such a spectacular delivery, but I thought I would open these up with you. So let's have a peek inside. Antique purple hydrangeas. Oh my goodness, I have just unboxed the two horizontal boxes and the taller box from Arena Flowers, and oh my goodness, it is safe to say I think they knew about my love of hydrangeas. There must be 10 or 12 giant pom-poms in this. I think they call it their antique purple, which is so spectacular. I think what I'm going to do with some of these is try out a method of drying out the hydrangeas, because I think they actually look potentially even more beautiful when they are dried out. And then this spectacular hand-tied bouquet, which has got so many lovely autumnal flowers in there. Got some beautiful roses. I think these are snowberries in white and in pink. This is just absolutely spectacular. I really hope that they still look good in 6 days' time, because that's when we've got Kat coming over. There's also this information leaflet with a little bit of info about how ethical they are, some of the lovely things they've done for charity, for providing flowers for the NHS, planting a tree for every single order, supporting the Crisis UK's coronavirus fund, loads of different things. And what I thought was incredible, it says that their subscription is only £20, including delivery, which I think is just incredible. So I will most definitely be ordering these when I would like to buy some flowers for friends in future. Just spectacular. Okay, now I need to arrange all these beautiful hydrangeas. My goodness, it is looking incredible in the kitchen. I've just bought this dried bunch from the fireplace to show you. So these were very kindly brought to us by some friends who came to visit the house a couple of weekends ago, Mike and Laura. And Charlie took them out of water at the exact right time, and they have dried so beautifully. This one used to be not too dissimilar to this kind of colour, and it dried this really beautiful deep purple, and then this was a lighter shade and somewhere in the middle, as well as eucalyptus. So if the new flowers from Arena dry anywhere near as beautifully as these, I will be very, very happy. So as you can see, the hydrangeas have formed these two beautiful bunches. Luckily, we've got quite a few big vases. If I can remember where these are from, I'll leave them linked down below. This one I think we got from a charity shop, and this one is from the White Company. They very kindly sent us this vase when we moved house. But at the moment, I have got them in some water, and at the perfect time, I will take them out of water so they dry, hopefully something a little bit like this. Darling, at what point did you take these out of water? Because they've dried so perfectly.
Yeah, well, I think that's the trick. So if you leave them too long, if you imagine if they're starting to wilt like a flower,
yeah,
then obviously they're never gonna come back. So you need to remove them when they look good.
Okay.
So actually, I remember taking them out. So like, for example, these,
yeah,
I reckon probably a week in the water.
Okay.
And then we'll take them out.
Okay.
Because they're so fresh, I mm-hmm. reckon these genuinely, hydrangeas in water will last for like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Like, they're the best, they're probably the best flower, best value flower to buy someone,
because
they last so long.
And they're so spectacular.
And then if you dry them out,
yeah,
shout out to like, Mike and Laura for these.
Yeah.
Beth and Andy, their ones are upstairs, aren't they?
And there's one from Beth and Andy over there.
Yeah.
The blue one. And the other one's up in my wardrobe room.
I mean, this one should maybe go in our bedroom or something.
It is just spectacular. Well, let's see how many bouquets. That one just looks so good by the fireplace. Let's leave it there.
Oh, no, but I think we're going to want to put these.
True. There. How nice if the whole house can be filled with dried hydrangeas. And I haven't even got to the main bouquet yet. I feel like I should say that this is not sponsored by Arena Flowers. They just so kindly sent so many. Quite tragic that I have to say that just because I speak passionately about something, but someone commented on one of my other videos saying, oh, you haven't disclosed that this video is sponsored by GHD, when it wasn't. I have never been paid by GHD, so it's just a little bit tragic, but yeah, I do. So that's what it's come to, not sponsored, just a passionate review and grateful chat about these flowers, which have very kindly been sent to us. What are you doing, darling? Rearranging.
I wanted to get rid of some of these leaves, because these leaves won't dry out particularly well.
I don't know, I thought they looked pretty good. It's like a florist in here. I'm not complaining. Okay, that's enough flower arranging for today. I've come up to my dressing room now, got my hair completely scraped back because I keep doing that really stupid thing where you don't properly, it's either I don't properly wash all the conditioner out of my hair, or more likely it's the oil that I'm putting in my hair afterwards, because I did try a new oil yesterday and it looks like I've just got slicked back hair, so it's not a terribly good look. But that means I'm not going to film a proper video up here today because the hair is pretty much unsalvageable. But what I am going to do, because I'm just feeling like I'm on the edge of getting a cold, you know, when you're just feeling a little bit low energy, so I've made myself a nice matcha tea, and inspired by Freddie's video that went live last night, I'm gonna do a bit of a wardrobe clear out. It's not that I need to make space, because I feel very fortunate that we have plenty of space, but a clear out is most definitely overdue. I do actually have some new things to share with you as well. This is the most gorgeous white faux fur coat that I treated myself to from Farfetch. Actually, I only ordered this a couple of days ago and it's come from Italy, so I'm very pleased with the speedy delivery. This was very much inspired by Victoria in the Fro. She featured this in a recent video, and I've been looking for something like this to replace my Topshop faux fur coat for quite a while, so I'm really looking forward to opening that. And I also have some lovely Topshop pieces to share with you, but I think before I get started on showing you those bits, I'm gonna actually begin with my coats over here. I'm not too sure if I'll be able to bring myself to get rid of any of these, because I do love my coat collection so, so much, but I feel like now is a really good time of year to potentially sell some of the coats that I just don't see myself wearing this year, and I'm going to put them on my Google Drive. I find that that's just the easiest way of selling my pieces, because if I just list them on Depop, I find that people mess you around a little bit, whereas the Google Drive is strictly for you guys, so I'll leave it linked down below and you can just drop me an email if you'd like to purchase any of the pieces. But yeah, let's start with the coats. Smart with my hair slicked back in a bun at trying on coats. It feels really silly, but so I've got some coats here that are definitely ones which I'm going to be parting ways with. The main reason is just because I seem to have quite a few duplicates, and these ones are all ones where I know that if I had a choice, I would just choose a different one to wear. I'm trying on a few now which are kind of maybes. This one has actually still got the tag in it. It's from Reese, and it is this beautiful, almost like a herringbone print to it, which is really, really lovely. It's actually not lined, but it's still a really gorgeous wool material, so it would be quite warm, but I feel like it's just potentially too much of a smart silhouette for what I need right now, so I think this is one that I'm going to part ways with. Okay, we are doing pretty well. I'm catching up on a few people's vlogtobers while I am doing this. So I moved on, as you saw, to my knitwear cupboard. And I just wanted to clear this out because I feel like I'm probably gonna be putting a few new knits in there. At this time of year, I just can't seem to resist beautiful knitwear. So a few that I'm getting rid of, this is, I believe this is Karen Millen. Yep, I've had this a couple of years and I don't think I wore it last autumn winter. It's a really elegant knit, but I feel like someone would be able to put so much more use to this than myself, especially if you want to wear slightly smarter knitwear in the office. I think that's a really, really beautiful one. The fit is absolutely gorgeous, size extra small. Yeah, I just feel like it's possibly a little bit smart for my current wardrobe. The same with this, really. It's a really beautiful one from Ted Baker with this pleating detail down the bottom and this beautiful pleated detail on the sleeves. It is an absolutely beautiful knit, but I just find that I'm reaching for slightly more casual pieces at the moment. This is a Sweaty Betty cashmere jumper. I just think I've got other workout jumpers that I slightly prefer to this one. Then we've got this Club Monaco off-the-shoulder jumper. I actually don't think I've ever worn this. I think the fact that it's off shoulder just means that I don't want to wear it outside, and it's not particularly easy for layering. Same really for this Under the Stories pearl jumper. I really want to love it, but as you can see, I've not worn it. I mean, brand new, £85, but the fact that it's still got the tag on, I didn't wear it all last winter, makes me think it's one that I should move on. This Reese fine knit, I do love in springtime, but again, I think there's others that I would reach for over this. The same with this Karen Millen Under the Stories jumper, Topshop roll neck, and my Maron hoodie. In fact, I think maybe I will keep that actually, because it's so snuggly to wear when it's really cold in the house. I'm thinking you want me for me. Isn't it my birthday yet? Cause I gotta say, you're looking like a gift for me. Wrapped up nice and neat, baby. Get in my way now, don't be shy. We'll be here dancing day and night. Okay, this really is a situation of out with the old and in with the new. So I've popped on my new coat and it is just absolutely gorgeous. It really is the kind of elevated version of the Topshop coat. Many of you that have watched me for a little while will know the one that I mean. To be honest, if Topshop had released that one again, I would have purchased it, but this one is just a little bit more elevated and I'm willing to invest because I know I'm going to get so much wear out of it. I'm not sure how many of these are left in stock, but if there are any left in your size, you can use my discount code, which is MumblrFF10, not just on this, but on all of Farfetch. So try your luck if you are also in the market for a lovely coat like this. It's a little bit more cropped than my Topshop one, but just as snuggly, a really beautiful big collar, nice big pockets. Yeah, literally exactly what I was looking for. So very, very pleased that this is exactly what I hoped it was going to be. It's actually roasting wearing this in here right now. So the brand is called Stand Studio. Not a brand that I'd heard of before, but that's one of the reasons I love Farfetch. They have so many lovely different brands. And it's called the Marina Faux Fur Teddy Coat, but I will leave it linked down below in case you are interested. Something else that I unboxed today was a very kind gift from Emu. So one of my favorite pairs of slippers, in fact, probably my favorite pair of slippers ever, my white, they're basically like this but in white, are from Emu, but I had to throw them away at the end of last year because they just got so battered. This year, they emailed me asking if I would like to take a look at their new collection, and I saw these. They're the same style as my white ones, but they've got slightly more of a brown kind of faux fur to them, so they're the same crisscross design, really easy to just slip on, and I live in slippers. I was actually discussing this with my friend Sophie the other day. We're getting through slippers so much more quickly this year just because we're wearing them so much more while working from home, so yeah, always been a big fan of Emu slippers. They also very kindly sent a pair of boots, and I think I'm gonna get a lot of wear out of these. Obviously I can wear them when I'm walking, whether that's through the village, going on a nice proper hike, or just want to get a little bit more dressed up for a dog walk. I love the faux fur detail, or the kind of shearling detail you've got on the lining of these. They are actually that same faux fur all the way down, so these are gonna be so nice and toasty and warm. I did go up a full size on these because I wanted to be able to wear them with nice thick socks. And these are called the Billington, and I got these in oak, the oak colour. It says they're waterproof, but I always spray anything new that's like suede or nubuck with liquid proof. It's come to that time of year where I start talking about liquid proof and thermals all the time. Liquid proof, you basically spray it on anything suede or actually anything, handbags, footwear especially. And if they get wet, the water will just bounce off as though it's like, I don't know, like it would bounce off a plastic surface, for example. So always worth spraying your new footwear. So I also went on a little bit of a Topshop shopping spree last week, and these are a few new pieces that I decided to purchase. I ordered this before discovering the stand coat, so I may not keep it, but it is a lot longer. So I feel like on really blusterous cold days when I want something a bit longer, this could be a really good option. Whereas the stand one I feel like is just a little bit smarter. Again, it looks very strange. I've got my hair slicked back. Oh, I actually really like this. Damn it. I was hoping I might send it back. So this is just one of those absolutely gorgeous, really cold days, pop on a scarf, pop on a hat. This really long teddy coat is the kind of thing that's going to keep you so, so toasty warm. You can, of course, do it up if you want to. Oh, if the wind is getting up and you want to keep your ears nice and toasty warm, again, really nice big pockets. Oh, I think I'm going to have to keep this one as well. I feel like where we live now, I'm going to be wearing a lot more teddy coats. They just feel very appropriate, whether I'm going out for a pub lunch or nipping to Soho Farmhouse. I think I'll get a lot of wear out of things like this. So also a really good, more affordable option if you do want a teddy coat, but maybe the stand one is a little bit above your budget. And it's slightly more creamy than the stand one, which is more of a pure white. So I feel like this one, I'll be a little bit less conscious of getting makeup marks on it as well. Next from Topshop, I was so happy to see that they brought out their faux leather ecru leggings again. So I did have these last year, but unfortunately my ones from last year no longer fit me after lockdown, and instead of trying to squeeze myself in like a sausage, I thought I would just pick up a new pair in a size that actually fits me. These are $39.99. I'm pretty sure they were $32.99 last year, but I know that I'll get so much wear out of them. As far as comfortable high street faux leather leggings go, these are one of, well, actually the best option that I've seen, because they do actually have some stretch to them. They've got this little detail here which gives them a little bit of a biker look to them. But what I love most is the fact that the lining is not fleecy, because that would just make them a little bit bulky, but it's almost like a brushed lining, so they just feel very, very comfortable. I wish the hardware wasn't silver. I don't really have much silver in my wardrobe, but to be honest, I don't usually like to have the top of leather or faux leather leggings showing. I like to wear something a bit longer. So yeah, I did size up this year for comfort and being able to eat a lot when I'm wearing them. So I'm going to try those on for you in a second. And I'm also just obsessed with cardigans at the moment, whether it's for popping on in the evenings when it starts to get cooler in the house, or to be honest, I'm pretty much wearing them all day. But I think I said in a vlog the other day, when I'm in the family room or the kitchen, it's actually really hot because we've got the fire and the Arga. So having a cardigan just means that I can fling it on, fling it off, depending on what room I'm in. So Topshop have just an absolute classic. Sorry, the sun is doing crazy things and I'm not set up lighting, just for this little section to show you these bits. But really nice, quite a casual silhouette. It's quite boxy, a little bit of a granddad cardigan style. It's quite fluffy, but nice and soft. I don't feel like it's gonna be itchy. Again, $39.99. I've gone for the size extra small because it did say that the fit was oversized, and I'm very glad that I did, because for an extra small, this is pretty big. And I like the back as well. It's almost like a ribbed detail. I don't know if you can see that there. So even though they're not quite the right colour match, I'll try this on with the leggings to show you how they look. So the white jumper really does clash quite badly with these leggings. They're almost like a pearly colour as opposed to a really pure white. So I've just popped on this And Other Stories hoodie, which I'm just loving at the moment. It's so, so cosy. The leggings fit absolutely beautifully. I'm really, really glad I sized up. They're just so much more comfortable. You can see in my reflection just how well fitted they are. I forgot how comfy they are with the brush lining. They literally feel like pajamas, they're so comfortable. If you are between sizes, I would definitely say to size up, just because of the nature of what they are. I think it can be quite unflattering if something like this is too small for you, because it just clings in all the wrong places. So I could even have gone up a size, to be honest. This is one up from my usual or pre-lockdown size, but I probably could have gone up another size again just for a different fit. But I do think this fit is pretty good, and this kind of length of jumper is definitely the length that I'm most comfortable wearing with things that are this fitted. I find that showing this area generally is just not hugely flattering, so things which just hang over the waist I think is the best look. But yeah, really, really pleased with the leggings. And here is the cardigan. I think this is possibly the best piece from the whole Topshop order. In fact, I don't think I've had a Topshop order in a little while where everything has been such a success. I feel like they went down a little bit of a dip during the middle of lockdown and early autumn, but they're starting to come back, which I'm very, very grateful for. So yeah, this is just a really beautiful classic piece. I love the color. It's very pure, very perfect winter white, that kind of vibe. Really nice chunky buttons. I like the fact that it's almost like a diamond knit on the sleeves, and then you've got the ribbed detail on the cuffs and on the back there. It's just something a little bit different. Nice low V-neck, perfect for showing off a pretty necklace. I have got mine tangled. This locket, I saw a few questions about. This is from Mumblr, and I have like an ongoing discount code with them, which I'll leave linked down below, and you can basically always get 20% off. So this is Mumblr, and my lovely pearl bracelet that I wear all the time is Mumblr. Excuse my chipped nails. I need to do something about those later. But yeah, cardigan is a resounding success. I've just popped it on with a pair of leggings because I'm pretty much gonna wear this now for the rest of the day. It's so nice and comfy and cozy. How much did I say this was? Take this off. $39.99. Yeah, I feel like this is just one of those things that you could invest a lot of money in because it's so timeless and classic. But yeah, Topshop have just ticked all the boxes with this one.
Oh, and you may have noticed I popped on my new slippers, and they are just absolutely gorgeous. I love that they've got the white underneath and then the brown as well. They're just so lovely. Thank you very much, Emu. Outfit of the day. Cozy version.
Oh, almost forgot to show you these. So I also ordered these in my Topshop order. I feel like Topshop are doing sunglasses so well at the moment. They've just got really on-trend shapes and styles which seem really, really classic. Let's see if I can get into these. Okay, I need to go downstairs and get a pair of scissors, but I think they're the kind of style where this bit is actually removable. It looks like it kind of clips on and clips off, but I thought they were rather lovely for an affordable pair of autumnal sunglasses. Also a really nice pair to just leave in the car. I feel like they're a little bit aviator-ish, so a nice pair of driving sunglasses.
Just come downstairs, and I'm now going to list everything on my Google Drive. Thought I would show you this lovely scene by the fireplace. It looks so gorgeous. So these are obviously the arena flowers, and I really like putting big blooms like hydrangeas here because it's really lovely when you can look down on them and see them from above, especially something as spectacular as hydrangeas. So can't remember if I mentioned earlier, but I did a little Google, and it said that when the flowers are looking fabulous, you basically hang them upside down in a dark, dry and fairly warm place. So I think I'll probably hang them in about a week's time in my wardrobe. So yeah, you may have seen in the speed hyperlapse earlier, I did do a little tester one, but they look absolutely gorgeous. And the fireplace looks even more beautiful than ever. So you may remember in a previous vlog, I showed you the sink and our new taps. As you can see, we haven't changed the plug hole to the gold one yet because our plumber that was here today didn't have the right tool with him. So it's going to come at another point this week to change that. But the silver taps, which were just not long enough for this sink, have now gone. And we've got the beautiful Burlington taps in here now to match the sink. And it just looks so much better, and obviously it's so much easier to wash our hands now because the spout actually fits the sink. Obviously it's a really beautiful big sink, and it needed longer taps, so Very, very pleased with that. What do you think, young man? Happy to confirm that the taps are working. You funny boy. You're keeping me on. Yeah, I'm strapped in. Stuck in a song. You can't. Perfect.
Let's go. Like a miracle round.
Back from our walk, and Charlie has created this. Looks like a pasta evangelist dish.
Got a few more pine nuts.
Oh,
yeah. That is hot.
Did you just grab a burning pan?
I've cut my finger as well. Having a bit of a shocker. You know, when you're just so hungry, everything is hard.
Yes. Do you want some more pine nuts?
No, I like
it. Yummy. I think tonight, after our pasta, Charlie and I are going to have an early night because we're both feeling a bit drained today. So we went out and had a walk to get some fresh air, but I think after this, we'll have a bath and go to bed, shall we, darling?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So as I usually do, or I'm trying to do, I'm going to say goodnight to you now before we have dinner, because we all know that Charlie and I have no energy after we eat and we just basically do nothing, have a bath if anything, and just have an early night. So darlings, thank you for watching today's vlog. Hopefully I'll have a little bit more energy in tomorrow's. I'm sorry if I've been a little bit of a downer today, or just not as energetic as usual. But yeah. I will see you tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. Good night.